Tan Sri, from academic academician, and then you move to politics.
When I was a student, I was involved through the NCWO, you know, National Council of Women's Organization. They invited me to help to give talks. Wanita UMNO and UMNO invited me to give talks. Yes, and then I became lecturer in 66. At that time, assistant lecturer, like tutor assistant lecturer. They invited me to give talk, economic talks all over the country at my own expense. I went. So I became known as pensyarah ekonomi lah. And I wrote articles every week in Utusan, Utusan Melayu, yeah, on economics, on consumers, on everything. Every week I got paid RM30 seminggu. For quite a while. And Uku Aziz recommended that I do a radio talk show every week dengan Harjit Singh Hulon. Every week. Economy di radio, imagine, and that is only for half an hour. So I learned to discipline how to say things in half an hour, and this is to help the very, very, very many Malay students and other students who did by that time economics in Malay, who had no access to books, who are too poor. So I was already the chief examiner for the whole country for economics. From Six Economics, I was the chief examiner. I don't set the exam questions, it was done by Cambridge. But I was the chief examiner, and I had a lot of examiners under me. Eh? For many years, I was chief examiner. But they thought that I should be able to guide students, not on apa, but to give them gist of topics, so that kalau they can learn, that they understand the concepts. You can imagine every week, lah, and it's played twice a week on the radio. So if you just listen to my radio talk too, you can actually have a D, a pass, or even a C plus. Yeah, if you actually understand, because at the end of the whole year, I will have question time. Harjit and si Jahari, yeah, was my student. Cikgu, macam mana ni? Macam ni? So there was question answer, you know. And I had many letters sent to me by students who went to university after that, whom I don't know, thanking me for what I did, because I didn't waste time. I went straight to subject. Today we shall talk about equilibrium. Today we shall talk about whatever, whatever. And I gave a gist in Malay. Those days tak ada buku Melayu. Yeah. And that was my service lah to the students. And many went to university. Dia kata based only on my talks and whatever they can, yeah. And whatever they can get hold of. In terms of articles ke apa, but at least for the basic understanding, I give it to them. Because without basic understanding, how can you expand, kan? Until I became a government, I joined government. Then I cannot lie anymore, kan? So I had to give up. I enjoyed it.
Were you the only Malay lecturers there?
At that time, yes. And then, well, my history panjang. Because I was the only Malay lecturer, I was very young, okay. I was masih tu belum 30 lah, yeah. And then at 30, I became a member of the University Senate. At the same time as I became member of Senate Parliament, so I was a member of two Senates, and I was appointed to the University Appointments Committee. So I sat there, and there was the late Prof. Mogzani, who had just come back from Oxford, and I'm interviewing him for his job. There was all these professors, not from economics, from other faculties, and I was sitting there interviewing them for their jobs. And later on in life, they would come and tell me, by the way, you interviewed me for my job as professor, kata apa benda kat situ, I nearly died, you know. This man, my father's age. I was 30, 31, and I went on lah, until I joined government. I had, I think, 3 years stint. With Tan Chee Koon, you know, this... members of the Senate, man, council members, and interview segala professor kau, you, they all got you tengok-tengok ni, oh, secretary ni kan. You learn responsibility lah. Never allow things to go to your head. That's important. You know, that's very basic. You know, you're just doing your job. Because you realize I was young. I didn't realize I was young. Oh my God. I just realized I was, yeah. Only I realized that, you know, when I go to Majlis Tinggi, like I told you just now, kan, Majlis Tinggi, when the entire Jing Bang were my father's contemporary who set up Pemuda UMNO. They remind me I was young. they remind me, you know, when they say, you know, I was your father, ni, I was, bila cerita, you know, here we are. They just wanted to remind me that, you know, that made me feel comfortable, and they were trying to maybe say, don't worry, we may be seniors here, but, you know, you are in your own. And it turned out very well. They were my best friends, actually, at that time. You wouldn't believe it. They were my friends, and they were my father's age, but became friends. They regarded me, you know, as a young girl, though, as a... Here I was pregnant kat Senet. I was pregnant twice in parliament. Yalah, kita muda. Kan? I used to wear ni, nail polish. I remember one of the seniors. Yalah, my father's kabar, ya. Eh, Rafidah, you ni pakai ni macam mana you semayang? Datuk, saya kat Senet ni, saya tak semayang kan. Saya balik lah sekarang, kita pun 6 habis kan. Masih ada lagi, asal kan. Ni benda ni, balik sekarang, ada tu, 2 minit habis. Bukan, dia bukan pakai liquid. No, it's just pieces of little pads already with the polish. You buat macam tu, hilang dia. I buy tins of it, you know, so little pieces. You take one, ching, 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 2 habis 10. In 2 minutes, they didn't know, man, nak tahu, dia ingat kita, macam ni nak semayang. Datuk, balik sekarang, first thing I do, sebelum wudu, ambil tu dulu, buang lah. Lepas tu semayang lah, besok saya pakai lah balik. Nak datang kat sini, saya nak lepas Zohor, kan? Saya nak start kot 2:30. Kan? Benda 5 minit je, kan balik, buang balik. Tak apalah, bazir duit, tak apa, nak melaram. Lagi jawab macam tu. I will have an answer. I will have a reason for everything. Otherwise, I won't do. If I know it can be done, why should I do it? Well, Tan Sri Fatimah appointed me to Economic Bureau without telling me. That's it lah. I was Vice President of Angkasa. I was waiting for Tun Razak to come because I was Chairman Organizing Committee. Before Tun Razak datang, every cabinet minister came and congratulated me, and I thought for having this big function, they went to the chancellor lah kan. Oh, chairman organizing committee, 3,000 lebih orang datang. Tahniah lah awak kan. Terima kasih. Not knowing what I was congratulated for. Then Tan Sri Fatimah datang, Datin mesti itu. Tarik ai. Alah Rafidah, awak jangan tolak ya. Tolak apa Datin? Saya dah lantik awak jadi Biro Ekonomi Wanita UMNO semalam saya pilih. Ha? Biro Ekonomi, tak tahu. Awak tak baca surat khabar? Tak, saya kat sini 6:30 tadi lagi. Datang tengok meja elok-elok, kursi elok kan. You know, awak jangan tolak ya. Ah, tak, terima kasih lah Datin. Tak apalah saya tak. Ha, terima kasih. Okeylah. Balik tengok betul lah muka saya. Macam wazir lah. Macam tu je. Tak ada lah siapa suruh dia lantik saya pun kan. Tak teringat pun, terperanjat nyawa je. And then Tun Razak appointed me. His Economic Bureau, and that was the story lah. Then 74, he appointed me senator. 75, somebody nominated me for majlis tertinggi. I said, okay, tak pergi kempen, tak apa, kita sibuk universiti. Menang. Menanglah sampailah saya retire 2013. From 75 to 2013, 38 years. Tak pernah putus-putus, you know, so. Senang aja. If you are being asked to do something, and people have faith in you and confidence that you can do it, you do it to the best of your ability. Jangan curi tulang. And on the other hand, if I feel I don't want to do it, or I can't do it, I don't want. First, I don't want. For whatever reason, I won't do it. And if I feel I'm not yet up to it to do it, but I should do it, I will try my best. You know, how do I get to do it? As best, macam lah jadi Chairman Asia Act, mana I tahu cerita kapal terbang. Kan? I don't know, head or tail of the plane lah. Don't tell me what type of plane. I have to learn. Otherwise, I'm just being stupid chairman there. Kan? So, I have to learn this plane. Itu pun I cannot learn enough because so many things. But I learned the basics. What goes into operating an airline, which is different from operating a restaurant, you know. Correct? I'm chairman of Supermax. Gloves, rubber base, no contact lenses. It's completely different plot from steel mill. I am also chairman of Pinewood Studios, which is a joint venture with Pinewood. Michelle Liu is my board member, where we give facilities for making films. I have to learn pula lah about film. So in other words, I cannot say no, I don't know anything. That's not right. You should learn. Alhamdulillah, you learn whatever is enough for you to get by. Because you never should have ambition. I am a person without ambition. You will never believe this, but my husband knows, my family knows, my parents know. I have no ambition. Ambition in the sense that I want to be like this, but I did. No, never. I always believe because life is short. If I know that God says you're going to live up to 80, I say, well, not like it's a plan, can? I always believe, how long do I have? When I was 20-something, sempat ke 40? Then you pass 40, sempat ke 50? You pass 50, sempat ke 60, sempat ke tengok cucu? That kind of questions to myself. So in other words, I have no time to plan. You do what you can now, because tomorrow kan tak ada lagi. Tomorrow nanti tak ada macam mana? And you miss already today. So I'm a very impatient person. I'm not a politician. I'm a technocrat. I'm a professional in politics. And I was taken in because of that, I believe. Not because I am a politician. I never was. I cannot be the run-of-the-mill politician because I do not know how to be politically correct. I had a team that worked. And in those days, there were no dengki-dengki, you know. There were no people who say, I want your post. Who, you know, people who didn't think that they had ambitions, they all came in and worked together. Because they know very well that if they work, they will be noticed. They will be recommended. That's what happened to me. So I did that for everybody. So the women became, some of them became deputy ministers, some became ministers, some became ESCO members. Some of them were very good at the grassroots level. So they became adun because they were there. They can't come to the, because, you know, some constraints kan, but they were excellent down there. They made very good wakil rakyat bekerja kan, because they live there. Oh, they should be. Why should we make them come to KL and mess up their life? Some are not very good at the grassroots level, kan? So we make them apa ni, work in some other areas lah, KL, where they can contribute them. Ini. So to me, it's as simple as that. You do what you can do. Not only I notice, but others notice too. But if you have ambition for yourself, you will definitely go astray and mess up everything, including yourself. And I'm seeing it happen all the time. Orang lain selamat, kau je yang tak selamat. Because of your intention, kan? Tak berkat. I live by the word berkat. Sometimes don't even wait. You know, this what you call this digital era, kan? Instant replay. Instant retribution. Being minister to wanita UMNO, being head school prefect, monitor of the class, no difference. It's just that you're leader of the pack. You must have a good team around you, like-minded, people with the same level of enthusiasm. And people have got different expertise, you know, so you galvanize. Ya, kata, this fellow more inclined to agama. Okay, she become biro agama punya leader. Yang ini suka sangat kerja volunteer, social. So, make her the biro social so that she can galvanize the NGOs and do all kinds of good things, kan? Ah, macam itulah. Well, let me put this way. Mahathir did me really good. He told me one day while we're having conversation, Rafidah, I put you there not because you're a woman, you know, because you're good. Wah, I came back and told my KSU, you know, made my day, even made my life. Because I think he wanted to tell that, look, I'm not gender biased. Because I've never been gender biased. If you're a woman, you're no good. I should not give you. Correct? Because the whole thing will suffer because I favor you because you're my gender. Just like you're a man, just because that's a man you take, that man is lousy. Why not take the woman who's better? That's what I mean. It's for the benefit of all. So gender should not be there. If I'm no good, don't take me lah. I'm not there of quota filler. I'm not your kekabu, you know, to fill a pillow. I always tell, if any of you cannot see that I'm a woman, something wrong with your eyes. Go over eye checkup. Working hard ni pun bodoh kat kerja tau. Working hard ni macam lipas on a pin ni, you know, ada pin tu, you letak lipas balik ni ha. 6 kaki tu bergerak, dia tak berjalan ke mana pun. So very busy ni. Very busy. but not going anywhere, the pin is stuck. So that's hardworking lah tu kan? No, work smart. Work right, work smart. Yeah. I started very young, much younger than that. I was with NCWO, I told you. Even before I was anything in Wanita UMNO, I was already with Datin Fatimah. I was the one who actually brought up through UMNO. Through UMNO, not Wanita UMNO. Because simultaneously, I was already in UMNO. Equal pay for equal work. Separate assessment for income tax. Tok Razak, canggok kat situ. I brought the resolution in UMNO, kat Dewan Bahasa. Because without bringing it through the party channel, it won't become government policy. So I had to bring it up. But we worked at the Wanita NCWO level where Wanita UMNO is part of it. So NCWO ni ada 22, tak salah I masih tu, organisation. So we worked for equal pay for equal work because especially in the civil service where women were temporary workers. They didn't have any permanent status. You know, that's how low class we were. You graduate same time, you permanent, you temporary. And then your income tax only as a wife, not as an individual. You know, you parasite, appendix. So first, equal pay for equal work. You got it. Second, assessment, separate assessment income tax. I am bawa resolution. Lepas present resolution, Tok Razak panggil. Panggil I. Naiklah ke pentas. Kak Esah dekat situ. I wasn't even deputy, no. Just exco je. Rafidah. Tok Razak kata, you ni minta ni semua working women ke? Ataupun just professional, salaried women. Wanita bergaji. Semua datuk? Oh, no. Semua kita tak boleh bagi. What do you mean? No. Kalau you change this to only salaried women bergaji, I can agree now. Kalau tidak, saya tak dapat terima. Because then it means all the lawyers, all the own account workers, you know. Because very difficult yet. Income tax not used to this yet. Belum siap dia punya structure tu, yeah. But for now, kalau salary senang lah kan. It's just all the payroll. But when you are on your own account, you know, you're a consultant, I mean, not easy lah to check your income, what you may put in sekarang, semua deductible kan. You know, it's the structure then was not made for this kind of separate. You're just an appendix as a woman, okay? I'm talking about women. To separate them, makna jadi assessment. If you're a lawyer, you are a lawyer, husband and wife, you punya income tax don't come under yours. You have a special file for you. Asing. And therefore, you get more deductions. Your expenses, your everything. You punya deduction as a wife tak patut lah, berapa ribu je. But she and her own, you know, in other words, she gets more earned income, betul tak? Residual income after tax. Than if she were taxed as your wife. Yeah, must be asing. So you got your file, I got my file. So senang, which means that you get net more. So, but that time, for these professionals, it's not that clear. I don't know, that maybe income tax kata dia belum sedia, you know, never thought of it. Kalau salary, senang. So anyway, then here was Tok Razak telling me this, and there was Kak Asa. I'm not about to consult her. She might even be lost, you know, in that argument. So I said, so what do I do, Datuk? Oh, you just change. You change yang mana? Ni ha, ni you cancel. Wanita bergaji, salary workers. Okay, can you change it? Yeah, I can. Dia ambil pen dia. Nah. So, I lah. Pen dia ni, atas. Orang semua tengok apa benda dia buat ni. Wanita bergaji, bracket, salary workers. Lepas ni sekarang, you pergi, lepas semua debate ni, you bangun. You cakap dengan speaker, you nak buat pindaan kepada usul you. Aduh. I tak sempat nak cakap dengan Kak Esah because telling her, I'm sorry to say, she will be lost because this is a very professional and technical because I prepared the whole thing myself with guidance from our people in the professions, you know, because I have friends, kan? Bangun saya, buat amendment. That's it. And that was in June, November budget, kan? Lulus budget. He kept his word. And we wanted a women's department. Masa itu dia baru jadi Perdana Menteri. Went to see him. And then, dia kata perempuan, saya faham. Tapi perempuan jangan lupa, kita ni baru merdeka. Remember, this is the 60s, kan? baru Mei 13 kan. Banyak lagi kita nak buat. Miskin, rural development, nyanyi. Saya faham wanita ni kita kena bagi fokus. Tapi saya janjilah, bila kita dah set semua structure kita, kita akan buat department wanita. Okay lah, he took his word for it. Then dia meninggal. Tun Hussein, pergi balik ke Tun Hussein. Tun Hussein kata, okay, within the year we will do it. So from Nasiwit, National Council for Women in Development. And that was the, we wanted a women's bureau personally. Then finally became a women's ministry lah. That's how we all started. Masih itu cari Zat, dari mana lagi, Tuhan tak tahu. I got Datin Fatimah, Bupalan, Ramani. Inilah orangnya. Oh, we were the core of the party. We let the men lah bercakap, bukan lantak korang lah kan, nak action ke. We work on the ground. Less talk, more work.